Don't try to apprehend him.
Alright guys, now moving to track number 9 from Ice Cube's America's Most Wanted album. This one's titled A Gangsta's Fairy Tale. It's featuring Lil Russ. I don't know who that is. I've never heard of him before. But I'm sure if he's good enough to be on the track with Ice Cube, he has to have at least some talent. You know what I'm saying? So without further ado, let's go ahead and hop right into it. I'm looking at lyrics, by the way, so let's go.
Once upon a time in the black part of the city.
Yo, G, you better get out of here, man. 5-0.
What's up, man?
Why you always kicking the shit about the bitches and the niggas? Why don't you kick some shit about the kids, man? The fucking kids.
Okay, interesting.
Little boys and girls, they all love me. Come sit on the lap of ICE and let me tell you a story or two about a punk ass nigga I knew named Jack. He wasn't that nimble, wasn't that quick. Jumped over the candlestick and burnt his dick. Ran up the street because he was piped.
Okay, this is super creative. I'm really liking this one. This one is super creative. Like, he's using kind of modern folktales to he's re-rapping over folktales, but like rewriting the folktales at the same time. This is so creative, man. I'm really enjoying this one off the bat. I'm only like 20 seconds in, but let's go.
And let me tell you a story or two about a punk ass nigga I knew named Jack. He wasn't that nimble, wasn't that quick. Jumped over the candlestick and burnt his dick. Ran up the street because he was piping hot. Met a bitch named Jill on the bus stop. Dropped the line at 2 and he had
that's
the hoe. At that type of shit, he's a pro. So Jack and Jill ran up the hill to catch a little nap. Dumb bitch gave him the claps. Then he had to go see Dr. Bombay. Got a shot in the ass and he was on his way to make some money. Why not? Down on Sesame Street,
no,
the dope spot.
Sesame
there is
saw the
lady who lived in a shoe. So dope at the front, by the back, marijuana grew. For the man that was really important, who lived down the street in an Air Jordan. Ride to the fella, Mr. Roger the Hose. Drove a 500 sitting on the Lorenzo's. He broke out, little old Pete smoked out. Saw her and her friend selling sheepskin.
Yo, got them sheepskins. Yo, money at the sheepskins. Yo, baby,
oh,
what's up?
Hickory,
this
dickory,
to be
top.
Bit, wow, this is
it
crazy,
was 12 o'clock.
Man.
Cinderella ain't home. Must be giving up the cock. I don't doubt it. She is kind of freaky, of course. Had a fight with Snow White. She was fucking her dwarf. Saw a fight over colors, too.
What?
Red Riding Hood and Little Boy Blue. A bad influence, yo, I don't know. But Ice Cube would tell the kids how the story should go.
Yeah, money.
This is crazy.
Just a little lesson to help. Rock that shit, homie. Rock that shit.
Well, you know the rest.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall with a joint, drinking some 8-ball. Three little pigs in a coop de ville, looking for the wolf to kill. That fucked up and they want revenge. Them and Humpty used to be friends. Now they're enemies cause he's a traitor. Pulled out the Uzi cruise by and sprayed him. Cinderella hoeing for the fellas. And Mr. Rogers is getting mighty jealous of the cash that the pigs were making. Time for the pigs to get turned to bacon. Cause
wow.
Mr. Rogers found out quick that Humpty Dumpty was blown to bits. They said that
so
the motherfucking wolf is next. So Mr. Rogers better watch his step. So he let the wolf know, we're gonna fuck up the pigs and take their hoe. Cause
Bruh, what? This storytelling is absolutely insane. Mr. Rogers is trying to kill. Oh, no, wait. Mr. Rogers is trying to kill the three little pigs because the pigs killed Humpty Dumpty. Or no, the wolf. I don't know. This is just insane, man. What he's doing with these stories, man. Like, transforming them into, like, ghetto. Almost like. Yeah, gangsta fairy tales, honestly, literally.
Rella is much too fast. Before 12, giving up ass. Double barrels all loaded and cocked. As soon as they show, they gonna get popped. They bailed down Sesame Street in quarters. Little Boy Blue was up front giving orders. Little did they know Cinderella was a fink. She called the cops, they got thrown in the clink. A bad influence, yo, I don't know. Ice Cube would tell the kids how the story should go. Hey, yo, man, was that dope enough for you?
Yeah, you are.
Better go home for whoop your little bad ass.
Some bedtime story, huh?
It's a nice place to visit, but I wouldn't want to live here.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that concludes one of the most just interesting storytelling songs from Ice Cube I've probably ever heard, honestly. That was just super interesting, the way he twisted the fairy tales into like a more ghetto-fied version, if you will. That was definitely interesting, man. I really enjoyed this one. I definitely am going to play this one back. No doubt, man. That beat and everything, like, it just flowed very nicely. And yeah, if you guys enjoyed this one, make sure you smack the like button, subscribe if you're new. And with that being said, much love, stay safe, and peace out.